So did you guys see SmackDown?
Want that wild boom.
Yes, it did.
Interesting. Just before we go over the review, what were your overall feelings of the show? Good or bad?
Some stuff was good. Some stuff I don't think they did a good job of, for being a go-home show. Some stuff I don't think they made me interested to watch WrestleMania, which is the job of the show. Is their last chance to make you interested in watching WrestleMania. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, SmackDown did a much better job than Raw as far as selling me on their matches. So
for sure, but SmackDown, to me, dropped the ball in a couple places, and we'll bring it up.
Yeah.
All right, so I'm eating cereal, so bear with me. The show opened.
Is that from the Nutrisystem box cereal or no?
Edge comes out. Says if anybody, Edge to the ring and said what happened to Fastlane last week didn't need to happen. He said he assumed Daniel Bryan would understand where he's coming from, and he meant it when he said that Bryan's return inspired his own. If anyone should see a manipulator coming, if anyone should see an opportunist coming, it's me, Edge said. Yeah, he was simply outplayed. He said he looked in the mirror and he finally liked what he saw. He said he saw the man who does whatever he has to do with his back up against the wall. I finally saw the rated R superstar. And then the triple threat thing came on the screen, and he said he finally woke up. He said he's the man that Reigns and Bryan aspire to be. He said he's the ultimate opportunist, and he's once again the rated R superstar. He said it felt good when the chair hit Bryan's body. He said he was so close to taking both out. He said it would happen again, and when it does, he won't hesitate. Do you like this promo?
Yeah, I thought this promo was good. Edge always cuts good promos. You know why? Because he doesn't say corny shit. And I liked some of the lines where he said, if anyone should see an opportunist coming, it's me, and I didn't. That's what Bryan is. Really, really good intensity. I actually like him more as a heel. And then he said something like, he thanked Daniel Bryan for awakening the rated R superstar, the guy who does whatever he has to do. I wonder if that little line will have something, will come into play in WrestleMania. But he almost reminds me of, like, remember when Batista came back and then he was overshadowed by Bryan?
Yeah.
You know, this almost feels the same way, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And it was just more heel character development for Edge, who's done a really good job.
Yeah, I like when they reference that, when Roman does, because it happened to Batista the one year, then the next year it happened to Roman, where the crowd didn't want him, they wanted Bryan. But it's weird, now that they reported the thing with Edge, the alleged report that Vince thinks he looks old, and that's why he kind of changed the match. Like, now I find myself really looking at his face. You know, like, he doesn't look that bad. Like,
no, he was looking a little bit worse, because I did notice that.
Yeah.
You know, he looked kind of creeperish. Like, he was really drawn out.
Yeah.
But anyways, I like Edge.
So then Caleb Braxton interviews him in the back. He said he wouldn't feel bad if Uso took out Bryan in the street fight. He was unable to work WrestleMania. Chad noticed in the ring,
which, just for people from a booking perspective, what they're doing here is they're giving him more heel character development, you know?
So, Chad Gable noticed, cut a promo in the ring. Dolph and Ziggler come in. This was an 8-man tag. And, the heels won. This is actually pretty, I mean, this match didn't mean nothing to me. I guess they're going for a thing on the pay-per-view where they're all wrestling each other again for a shot at the titles. Did I read that correctly?
I don't know. I don't think Rey is in WrestleMania, which is kind of weird, because that would have been great, good, feel-good story.
How was he done at WrestleMania?
No, they're doing what they're calling DI WrestleMania SmackDown. So a few of the matches that are scheduled are going to be on Friday night instead of in front of the crowd on Saturday and Sunday.
Really?
And Rey's match is one of them. I'm going to look up the rest. I'm not sure.
Anyways.
All right.
So I think they gave their spot to that 10-woman match, which this would have been way better. I also would like I got reminded of something when I was watching this match. What a cheesy, brutal Bob Evans name they gave Ziggler and Rude. You know what they're called?
The Dirty Dogs.
Yeah.
I don't mind that.
I don't like. Sounds like a 90s name.
Maybe a 90s name, but I think you could put that. I think it's more marketable than Street Profits.
Yeah, well, I don't like either one.
Well, think about all the teams that are named like with dogs, like Bulldogs, the
Pit Bulls.
I mean, so yeah, I mean, I'm just saying, like, the dog slogan is kind of like it's out there. I think people will buy that. You know,
I just think it's kind of played.
It sounds corny, but it's a brandable name.
The Moondogs.
Yeah, I wouldn't call them that.
Who's better, the Moondogs or the Dirty Dogs?
The Moondogs.
Moondogs. They're great.
Paul Heyman approached Adam Pearce and Sonny Deville and said Roman's wanted him to talk to them. and he requested a hold harmless agreement for Jey Uso on the street fight, and Pierce started to respond, but Deville interrupted him and said she thought Heyman made a good point. So do I, Heyman said, walking away. So this is the tease. Now, I guess Adam Pearce and Sonya Deville are not going to be seen eye to eye because she liked something and Adam Pearce didn't.
Right. And he was very condescending to Adam Pearce. But also, let me say one thing, because a lot of people, they listen to our reviews of the match and they go back and watch him. This last match was really good because for a while now the mid-carders have been showing improving. And I also like the enthusiasm of everybody involved in the match. You can see their body language on the apron. They're selling all the big moves. There's good chemistry and energy. This was a really good match.
Next is they do a face-off in the ring with Graves and Cesaro. I don't even know how to describe this. This did nothing.
Right.
The two of them were in the ring. They were wearing suits. Rollins' suit was obnoxious.
Yeah. Oh, he's brutal. Did you see the?
It was an obnoxious. But he's a heel though.
He's doing it on purpose for the.
Yeah, but you didn't see the Hall of Fame last night, right?
No.
Oh God, his interview was so obnoxious. He keeps talking about the drip or something, and he comes across very, very lame, very dad jokey.
Rollins got worked up and said he would end Cesaro's dream on the spot, and Cesaro told Rollins to take a swing and then drop the mic. Rollins backed down by leaving the ring while the production team piped in boos.
Okay, so here's my point on this. They're in WrestleMania, right?
Mm-hmm.
As I said, the go-home show is your last chance to get people to watch WrestleMania, and they did nothing to make me want to watch it. For the most over thing in this whole thing was Seth's hideous suit, okay? Mm-hmm. Bro, Cesaro actually said at one point, swing is in the air, and he sang it like that old school song. Bro, Cesaro never has been and never will be good on the mic. This, for a go-home promo or angle, was not good. Make me want to watch this match at all. I thought they did a bad job of building it up and terrible promos to boot.
So Nia and Shayna Baszler and Reginald were walking backstage to come across Carmella and says, oh, you didn't treat my guy very well, did you? And they walked away. So that was like, Carmella's been doing nothing since she's lost Reginald. Shayna Baszler against Natalya lasted 35 seconds. Natalya beer in 35 seconds. Yeah. After the match, Carmella was shown watching the match on a monitor in the ring. Jackson Baszler roughed up Natalya and Tamina. Then here we go. Ruby Riott and Liv Morgan ran in and then the performer spiked DDT on Jax. Baszler put a finish on Riott. Mandy Rose and Dana Brooke ran out and joined the fight. Lana and Naomi ran out and fought the other teams. Italian Tamina performed a modified heart attack clothesline on Lana and were the last team standing. This was laid out very well and performed very poorly. So this
It was just a bunch of girls doing moves to the ones that came in after them. Mm-hmm. With that spike DDT that they gave Nia Jax, I kept, while it was being set up, I thought, let's see how Nia messes up this bump. But she actually got spiked and took it perfect. But this is the match. That match is the one that's going into WrestleMania instead of the tag team match with Rey. Yeah. And Lana should not be doing planchas or anything athletic.
So basically, the next thing is Logan Paul arrives on the red carpet. Sammy's acting like he loves him. They're hugging him. He's over the top. Logan Paul's acting a little bit uncomfortable.
He's an excellent dancer, Sami Zayn, by the way.
Yeah. So basically, he showed the trailer. When they were in the ring, they showed the trailer. It's ridiculous. Zayn asked Paul what he thought. Paul said it was a lot to take in, and Paul told him that he spoke with Kevin Owens, who told him that Zayn is delusional and there is no conspiracy. And Zayn said Paul was his guest of honor, not Owens' guest of honor. He got really uncomfortable with him trying to show him up here. Zayn apologized, said he could see that he offended Paul. Zayn said he knows what Owens thinks. He doesn't care because he doesn't want him poisoning Paul's mind. Zayn asked Paul what he thought, and Paul said he could tell that Zayn put a lot of effort into the trailer. And then Owens showed up and gave him a stunner out of nowhere. What did you think of this?
I thought this was great. I thought Sami Zayn was incredible, bro.
And, yeah, this is good. I liked it.
Yeah, and then I thought Logan was good. He wasn't like Bad Bunny or Ronda Rousey, who's overwhelmed by the moment. You know, I thought he was good in his role. I just think it was really weird, and I wonder if somehow Logan will help Sami Zayn in his match, because right before Kevin Owens left, he pushed Logan.
And he gave him a little, yeah.